So, some people think that music is worship. Could you speak a little bit and kind of clarify? Is music worship? Is it, or is worship not music? What is the relationship between the two, if you will?
Thanksgiving is our response to the acts of God, his works. Praise is our response to his nature, his character. Worship is our response to his presence. The root word of worship is to kiss. It's a very intimate, tender response. Worship can include music. Oftentimes it does, but it doesn't have to. It's more accurately a surrendered response of the heart. And it's honest, it's raw. In fact, John 4, Jesus talking to the woman at the well, he said, the Father is looking for worshipers, those who worship in spirit and in truth. In spirit is under the anointing direction of the Holy Spirit. In truth means nothing hidden. So it means completely empowered by, and there's no, I have no dark closets in my life. Everything is bare. I give it all in worship. And it doesn't say that the Father's looking for worship. He doesn't need my affirmation. He doesn't need me to make him feel better about himself. I actually need worship because I always become like whatever I worship. So if that's true, then he could want nothing better for me than for me to worship him because I become like him in that activity. And so the Father looks for worshipers, not worship. And so, yes, times it includes music, but it's the continuous. I think it's the heart and soul of what it means to abide in Christ in John 15. It says, abide in him, let his words abide in you. You'll ask whatever you want. So to have a prayer life that changes the course of history, it comes because you dwell on his word. But there's this heartfelt response to his presence, which I think the most accurate response is worship.
So you said sometimes music includes, sometimes worship includes music, but
Yes.
it sounds like most times is, doesn't necessarily.
No, it doesn't.
It's not the point. What would you say to the musicians that are just great at music, but want to be great worshipers? What is some practical advice that
Well,
you can give?
do it when you're by yourself. Best thing I can tell you to do, you can't lead people in public where you've not gone in private. You can play songs, you can lead them in external expressions, but you can't actually take them into the realm of glory, and that's the goal. You can't take them into the realm of glory if it's not a place that you enter into on your own. And don't measure your success by some external experience. Just give yourself for his glory. It doesn't matter, if you don't play an instrument well enough to lead, yourself into that place of presence, or maybe you just play, an instrument that doesn't necessarily lead in worship. Still, do it. Just play your best as unto the Lord. Put on a CD. Put on, put music on your phone. But really enter into that place on your own. And music is a great instrument and a great tool. It is a supernatural expression, so it's extremely valuable. And that's why the enemy works so hard to pervert the influence of music in culture and society. It's because of its power. It has power. But it's without it being yielded to the Lord as an expression of honor to him. Well, the devil himself is described as having musical instruments in his being, in his person, and he fell looking for his own glory. So it's a glorious but dangerous tool. So just always just give it all to him. Just give it all to him, but in private, just learn to worship. It just I used to just go to the church, the sanctuary. Where we were in Weaverville, and I would just spend sometimes hours just walking through that room, just worshiping the Lord, just hands raised, voice raised, sometimes shouting, sometimes dancing, sometimes kneeling, sometimes laying on my face. It's whatever I felt was the most appropriate response. And that's what you want to do. You want to be free enough to be honest, free enough to be honest. And that was huge for me. And the personal breakthroughs I would get in that area actually helped to pave the way for corporate breakthroughs. that we experienced as a church. But it started first me one-on-one, then a small group, you know, three or four people we'd worship. I'd sit down at the piano and play the two or three songs I knew, you know, over and over again, and we would just worship. And it didn't have to be pretty. It was just honest.
Wow, free and honest. That's powerful. Wow.